Well, hi, Don. Appreciate you taking my call. Did you get an opportunity to see the map that I sent you?
Yes.
What are your thoughts?
I think you have the wrong location. It's a little bit further south.
Further south?
It's further south, yes. On Richard's ranch. Richard's adjoins the very ranch where the debris field was located.
Okay.
A number of witnesses have indicated that Dan Richards managed to steal a piece of the debris from the actual crash. He was a witness to the cleanup activity at the very debris field site. And I believe we can introduce you to the very people living at the ranch.
We went to Guy on his peak on what Sandy Proctor told us about the map. But once we got there, it kind of didn't make sense. When I flipped the map over, it pointed right towards the Richards family ranch. Now it looks like these pieces are slowly coming together.
If you're able to get inside at all, at least give me a report one way or the other. I'd love to hear.
If I can get in there, I will take a selfie and send it to you, okay?
The team has targeted a new area to search for the Roswell wreckage. But first, they'll need the approval of Dan Richards' descendant, who has agreed to meet him, only if his identity and the ranch location remain a secret.
So Dan's cave has been kind of a secret in the family for decades now.
Sir, what happened with the material?
Back in 47, him and a bunch of ranchers were gathering and they came across a crash site.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Dan picked up a couple of pieces of it and hid it away in his cave. He ran a couple of tests on it, and it couldn't be cut by torch, couldn't be burnt, couldn't be cut by hacksaw or clippers or anything. But you could take it in your hands, crumble it up like tinfoil, and open your hand up, and it would pop out to its original shape.
In 1947, the U.S. Army Air Forces launched a top-secret project called Operation Mogul, which involved microphones flown on high-altitude balloons used to detect sound waves generated by Soviet atomic bomb tests. In 1994, after public pressure to resolve the controversy behind the Roswell incident, the government released declassified documents and claimed the remnants of the crash belonged to one of these balloons.
According to family legend, he took these pieces of metal and hid it away in what the family considers Dan's cave.
Are you telling me that this location could house alien debris?
It possibly could, yes.
Have you ever tried to go check it out for yourself?
My family members have discouraged it.
Why?
Because they don't want it found. My grandmother and my great-grandmother tried to keep me away from this area. They said it's dangerous.
I'd just be curious to see what's underneath here and how we can get to it. Are there any other known entry points that we might be able to look at?
There's a possibility of another cave entrance, but nobody would tell me where it was.
So then, of course, you know, I have to ask, you think that's entrance, why haven't you got a bulldozer out here and...
Yep.
Family members.
Family members, okay.
Do you mind if we take a look? If we get an opening large enough, we got a camera that we can snake in there. See if we see anything.
I would love to see what you guys can find.
Let's do this.
Yeah. And there goes Dan, out there looking for another entrance. What's the pile of rocks over there?
Okay, that is a boundary marker.
Okay, is it a BLM boundary marker?
Yes.
Okay.
It's corner section marker.
Oh, corner section marker. But this is still Richard's
ranch, yes.
Okay. And it goes on beyond that.
And our private property stretches from there over to that hill right over there, and then goes north to the top of that hill over there, and then goes east.
This is beautiful out here. Just beautiful.
Yeah, and from here you can see the Capitan Mountains, especially when it snows.
What's the nearest town to you?
The nearest town is Corona.
Okay, there's not much there, is there?
Corona is in which direction from here?
It's northwest.
Okay. Mountains are there, so it'd be that way.
So we're not far from the debris site?
No, we're actually less than 5 miles.
Wow, yeah.
His family is super determined to keep his cave hidden. It makes you wonder why. What are they trying to hide?
This definitely looked like cave area, huh?
Yeah, it does.
Just the way the rocks are set up.
Is there anything else that we can see back farther? Like a pole or something?
Well, I mean, I got that pole back there in the back of the truck. They put the camera at the end of that and just take it down to where it starts to curve. We might be able to get something.
I'm gonna grab that and see how far it goes back. So we're losing light. If that camera reveals that it's big enough for me to get in there, I'm going in and I'm gonna get some answers.
It's going in. It's in the hole.
All right, see.
See anything? It looks like it's closed off on me.
No, it goes back further. See right there? It's just that because we were shoveling, we pushed some dirt in front of it, didn't we?
That's the top.
Yeah, you can see where we pushed dirt in front of it.
Try going to the right.
Yeah, he'll have to pitch around, you think?
Oh, look, it goes in there, too.
Look at that. Hey, look at that.
So it opens up to the right, too.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. You know, guys, over 70 years ago, something happened just on the other side of the hill a few miles back. It changed this part of the world. Debris was scattered everywhere, and this area is the exact place where someone could have found debris and hid it in the cave. And this could be the cave. This is exactly what we were looking for, exactly. Who knows what it looked like back in 47, but this is definitely in the right area. This is where their ancestors said that debris was hidden in caves. And this is it. This is the location right here. Now we need to find out whether or not we have debris in there.
Make it just a little bit wide, and I might be able to slide in there.
You want to try it?
I mean, we're out here, right? Let's do it.
What do you think?
That was kind of tight.
Chuck.
Just as the team is picking up steam, Dan Richards' descendant returns with disappointing news.
My family members have found out that you are here. They like their privacy, so they're not that much into people poking around where they don't need to be.
Well, because this is an active investigation.
That's the problem. This location is now blocked off.
For unknown reasons, the Richards family has put a halt to the team's excavation.
I don't know. Maybe the family wants the debris for themselves. Maybe they're afraid that the military may come in and take the debris from them, might harass them. I don't know, but I'm really disappointed right now. Okay, guys, that's it. Pack it up. We're getting shut down.
I turned it off.
There's just no way to walk away from this.
We have to.
For now, we have to. We may be shut down for now, but we're gonna find out what's in that cave one way or another.
I think we're getting closer.
One step closer to the truth.
Let's go.
Okay.